So what we have in this problem is a merry-go-round which is moving with an angular acceleration of 1.5 radians per second squared, and its initial angular velocity is 0. And let us say it starts at this position so that the angular position is at 0 degrees or 0 radians. So the question is, what is the time taken to do the first two revolutions? So the equation we'll use is theta minus theta naught is equal to omega naught t plus half alpha t squared. Now we have to find how much time it takes to do two revolutions. That is, the final theta value or the angular position would be two revolutions, and we convert it into radians, which is 2 pi, and its initial position was 0. So we put a 0 over here, and this should equal omega naught t, which would be 0, plus half into alpha, which is given as 1.5 radians per second squared, into time square, which we have to find. And what we find is that t is equal to 4.09 seconds. So the second part of the problem is, and let's label this as the first part. The second part is, how much time does it take to do the next two revolutions? Now, to find what is the time taken to do next two revolutions, we'll find what is the time taken to do four revolutions, that is first two plus next two. To find the time taken to do four revolutions, we'll use the same equation, but on the left hand side this time, the total displacement would actually be four revolutions into 2 pi, and therefore it converts into radians, minus the initial position was 0, equals 0 plus half into alpha, which is 1.5, into t square. And now the t value, if you solve for t, what you get is 5.78 seconds. So you can say that if this is the time to do four revolutions and this was the time to do two revolutions, then the time taken to do two revolutions after the first two revolutions is nothing but t4. Minus t2, which equals 5.78 minus 4.09 seconds, and this equals 1.70 seconds.